giving this talk?
Actually, I've been giving this talk about 4 years, which is pretty unbelievable. I wrote it. I wrote it because I was really aggravated about our invisibility, and a good friend of mine asked me to come give her keynote. And so I asked her what I should speak on, and she said, "Oh, whatever you want." No one ever tells me that. And that's how it happened. You know, it was really, I thought about that. She wanted it to be motivating. I was pretty sure I could make it motivating. And I mean, the bottom line, the name of the talk is Stop Hiding and Change the World. And I wrote it specifically for the lab animal community because I believe they have a very special role in communicating what we do to the public. I mean, you look around you, and by the way, thank you very much for the opportunity to come here. I mean, the Charles River Short Course is a place I've always wanted to go, and so here I am, and that's really wonderful. And it's a fantastic program, a fantastic group of people. And look at them all, right? So you're surrounded here by people with an inordinate selfless love for animals and people, the likes of which you don't find in just about any field, not even ICU nurses, right? So these are folks who love animals and people so much that they sign on at great emotional cost to them very often to improve the lives of animals and people day in and day out. So this is a population of people that the public knows nothing about, right? And yet, these incredible heroes, these are people who create someone's miracle every single day. This group of heroes hides whenever the topic of what it is they do comes up. They turn away, they don't want to talk about it, and they've been forced into this reflexive hiding place. And that's because of the effect that the extremists have had on the understanding of the general public, right? And so the only people who have really been talking about animal-based research to the general public is this tiny fraction of extremists whose agenda really doesn't have anything to do with animal well-being so much as it does ending all of our meaningful relationships with animals on every level. And so they've had an exclusive audience, the public, and so the public just sort of heard their misinformation over and over and over, and they just keep listening to this. They hear this one reel of truth, and they've heard nothing else because we haven't said anything else. And so after a while, if you just hear that reel over and over and over again, whatever it is you hear becomes the truth. And in the absence of any other truth or any other comments, that's it. That becomes your truth. And then, in fact, the extremists use that to their advantage, and they say, well, you haven't heard from them. And that just validates what we've said because they don't want to disagree with us because they know it's true. And so it's been a disaster for us, right? I mean, if you look around, every time you turn around, you see somebody who's survived cancer, who's living with diabetes, war veterans who are home now sharing their lives with their families instead of dead, which would have not happened 20, 30 years ago. I mean, the world has changed in incredible ways because of these heroes right here, and yet they won't say anything. And the public, even though that's obvious, is missing it because they believe what they've been told. And so this whole discussion is first really about empowering these incredible people to realize what it is they're doing, you know, this incredible mission of love that they've been on, that very few people could do, and then giving them some skills to start sharing what it is they do with the public. And what I found personally, even through grad school and op, is that when people understand that there's a laboratory animal science profession, because the extremists haven't told anybody that on purpose. They don't want anybody to know about us, because that blows a lot of holes in their arguments, right? So the extremists want the public to think that there's somebody like, I don't know, Frankenstein up in some closet somewhere who doesn't know how to brush his hair, you know, let alone take care of animals, and you know, that suits their agenda, which again has nothing to do with animal well-being. And so this population of people, I think it's a special role because we really are the bridge to public understanding. Whenever I've had conversations with the public about these incredible people, their special training, their special commitment, their special love, their heroic efforts, the public is so grateful. I mean, they thank me. Sometimes they hug me, and that's okay sometimes, right? They cry, but they have always thanked me, and they've always said the same thing. Thank you for telling me that. Thank you for making me feel better. I didn't know that, and I can't wait to tell my wife who's an animal lover, and I can't wait to tell my aunt who's an animal lover. I mean, so we have a huge role in this, and the thing about it is, we should remove all of the arguing, right? So we don't have to argue with anybody, and sometimes people will say, oh, well, why don't you debate the extremists? Two reasons. For one, I'm not interested in talking to them. Those aren't the people I want to speak with. They have their mind up. What I want to speak with are the masses who have already been lied to by the extremists, who need some real information to make some informed decisions, because the extremists have convinced them to harm themselves. They've convinced them to vote for things that will harm them and their children and their grandchildren, and they don't even know it. So that's number one. Number two, I don't debate about important issues like this, because debating and this us and them is part of the reason we're in this situation to begin with, right? And there's always a I'm right and you're wrong, and debates by default have a winner and a loser, and I don't think that any more arguing is going to be beneficial. I think we need to change our direction from arguments and strong positions that are against one another, and instead get together and start having some conversations about the real truth, all of it, the good, the bad, the ugly. Put it all on the table, discuss it, get the public involved in that dialogue, a truthful dialogue about all of it, including their accountability in all of this. They demand these cures, and then they want to pretend that they come from nowhere. It's time to have that conversation as well. And then get together, and instead of arguing, start looking forward and solving things, right? What we need are more solutions and less arguments. So I'm more interested in having conversations with people, and that's what this talk was about. This talk initially was about mobilizing this amazing, very unique, incredibly loving, compassionate workforce, the lab animal science community, to start sharing their message, because I think it, they have something really special to say that resonates very uniquely in the hearts of the public.